Now, eczema usually starts in your childhood, but it may persist throughout your entire life. Some adults grow out of eczema, but not all do. Hey there, welcome back to How to Medicate and welcome to this new video on how to treat eczema. This video covers everything you need to know and is part of a video series on your skin. If you're looking for more of these videos, then check out the playlist in the description. Before we start though, a quick introduction. My name is Raoul, I'm a medical doctor from the Netherlands and I'm making weekly medical videos to educate myself, as well as you, my viewer, because I believe that medically educated people make healthier decisions and that is what this channel is all about. Before we start though, a quick disclaimer, this video is meant purely informative, this is not medical advice, and if you're looking for medical advice, always contact your own doctor, and let's get started. So in this video, we will cover the treatment of eczema, but before we do so, I wanted to cover what eczema exactly is in a nutshell. Eczema, also called dermatitis, is a group of diseases which can cause inflammation of your skin. And this is due to a disrupted skin barrier, which can lead to the loss of moisture, a dry skin, and a decreased protection from the outside world. There are many types of eczema, but the most common one is atopic eczema. This type of eczema is characterized by redness of your skin, itchiness, dry skin, and a rash. It might affect a small area of your skin up until your entire body. The exact cause of eczema is unknown, but it's thought to be a combination of allergies as well as problems with the veins inside of your skin. Therefore, the strongest contributing factor are your genetics, but there are other factors which are important as well. Climate factors, stress, skin bacteria, usage of soap, sweating, and wearing wool clothing. Now, eczema usually starts in your childhood, but it may persist throughout your entire life. Some adults grow out of eczema, but not all do. And it's estimated that about 245 million people were dealing with eczema in 2015, which is more than 3% of the entire population, which makes my video quite relevant. So please leave a like, this will let YouTube know it's worth recommending to others, which might find this video helpful as well. Thank you. And now we're all up to date on what eczema is, we can cover the treatment options. Here is important to note that eczema is a chronic condition. Unfortunately, there is no cure that can help you get rid of it indefinitely. Instead, it needs to be controlled with proper skincare and, if necessary, medical treatment. And we start off by skincare. First of all, make sure to moisturize your skin twice a day, in the morning and in the evening. You do this by applying a thin layer of oily ointment or cream, which also might decrease the itching. Next up, make sure to never scratch. Just tap the skin lightly where it is itching. You could also apply bandages, which help to protect your skin and prevent scratching. You could also take a warm bath with baking soda or uncooked oatmeal. Soak 10 to 15 minutes, then pat yourself dry and apply moisturizer if your skin is still damp. Always use mild soap without perfumes or any dyes, and make sure to rinse it off completely after you put it on. Use a humidifier to prevent hot and dry air indoor, and always try to decrease stress and anxiety. You could do this by meditating or purposely doing something fun when you're feeling stressed. And this brings us to the last step, the medical treatment, maybe the part of the video where you all have been waiting for. There are several different treatments which your doctor could prescribe you. Some to control the itching and repair your skin, like corticoid cream or ointment, or tacrolimus. These lower the immune response of your own body and decrease inflammation. Another option could be the use of antihistamines, which also decrease itching. Next up, your doctor could prescribe you drugs to fight off an infection. These can be used when one of the cracks in your skin is infected. Then a topical or an oral antibiotic can be prescribed. And one of the last options there is light therapy. Here UVB rays are used to decrease the inflammation in your skin and to prevent eczema from worsening. Now I hope you learned something, because that was the whole point of this video. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. And if you enjoyed, please leave a like. So it will help out the video tremendously. And if you want to keep on learning, then check out the playlist in the description or somewhere up there. And before you go, consider subscribing. This will help me out to reach my new milestone, 10,000 subscribers. And I would be eternally grateful. Thank you for watching. And as always, I will see you next week with a new video. Bye bye.